Now President Obama's inauguration has stirred up controversy within the Phoenix Police Department over gender and skin color. Kevin Kennedy joins us live from Phoenix PD tonight with more on the accusations. Kevin?
Yeah, let's see. Three Phoenix police officers are claiming discrimination. They say the police chief selected officers to work the inauguration based on skin color and gender. The three officers that filed that claim, all three are white, all three are men.
Are you prepared to take the oath, Senator?
The presidential inauguration, Phoenix police selected to serve 40 officers from four units will head to D.C. But it's who's going and who isn't that has the police union furious.
This is, in my opinion, extremely egregious, flagrant, fundamental violation of EEO, outright discrimination based on race.
That claim specific to how members of one unit were selected. An email obtained by 12 News shows a commander directed by Chief Daniel Garcia requesting the gender and race of all officers being considered.
This is blatant, fundamental, basic discrimination, racial discrimination.
Here's a copy of the list. The nine officers selected from this unit are all minorities or women. The three alternates, white men who have seniority. Barry Jacobs, not on the original list, one of three officers who filed a grievance.
The only reason that I was cast up for that list came out was because I was not the right skin color or the right gender.
A grievance settlement was reached. All three officers signed off. Case closed, right? Far from it.
I, as well as others that have been affected by this, have never been given an apology. No responsibility has been taken by any level on this department whatsoever.
An EEO claim is under investigation. Jacobs plans to file a federal complaint, and the union wants the chief and two other high-ranking police officials suspended.
So this is something way ahead of what we have in this facts in hand. We had a grievance that was resolved. We now have an equal opportunity claim that's being investigated.
That investigation could take weeks. A new list has since been generated, one that includes two of the three white officers who filed the initial claim. Barry says the worst part of all of this situation is the fact that no one from the police department has offered him or the other officers any sort of an apology. We did try to speak with someone from the police department. They got back to us late tonight, essentially referring to all of our inquiries back to the city manager's office. As for Barry, he is now the second alternate on that updated list. We're live in Phoenix. I'm Kevin Kennedy, 12 News.